try to become like Maven.
Oh, absolutely. You're right. So, let's say, try to win Tough Enough too. I can't wait to watch it, like you said, right after SmackDown. But don't do as Maven did. I mean, if you win, sure, you get a contract here in the WWF, but be humble. Be a rookie. Come in. Don't try to throw your weight around like Maven did with The Undertaker. Don't go up against guys like that right off the bat. Be a big shot. It'll cost you down the road.
Who will be the next Maven? And look at this. The bizarre Goldust. This is ridiculous. What is up with this guy?
I don't know what's up with this guy, but I do know what is up with this match. This is a hardcore match where weapons are legal, Michael. Unlike Stone Cold bringing a weapon out here earlier, that was completely illegal and uncalled for.
Okay, I understand your point about Stone Cold Steve Austin. Perhaps he did go over the edge a little bit here tonight. Perhaps. But Stone Cold Steve Austin has lost it. He has been provoked. He has been backed into a corner, and he is a wounded rattlesnake who is facing a pack of rabid dogs, King. Well. And he has nothing else. He can't do anything else. Oh, a shot.
Oh, you can say Austin's lost it. I don't know if he ever had it, but he'll never get it if he keeps running afoul of the NWO.
And Goldust hammering away on Maven. This is a hardcore championship matchup. And you have to believe it's Goldust delivers that big right hand to Maven. Here's the cover, hook of the leg. There's two and a kick out. I understand that Tough Enough casting special tonight is wonderful. It takes place out in Las Vegas. And what an event. Good old JR was a big part of it.
Well, I'm going to tell you what I've just heard. Oh! Speaking of good old JR and sources, my sources have told me, look at
that. Oh, wow.
That's a rookie mistake. My sources told me that the NWO, Michael, had left the building. They left right after that vicious attack by Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah, because they're a bunch of cowards.
No, I'll tell you where they're going. I bet they're going to the police station here in Boston. They're going to probably file charges against the
Yeah, because they don't want to fight Austin man-to-man.
No.
It's always got to be 3-on-1. Well, it's always got to be a pack of dogs, King. It's always got to be run away when the odds aren't in our favor. That's what it's all about. Oh, look out. Totally legal in this matchup, that trash container to the head of Maven.
Oh, man. Let me ask you this, Mike. Are you trying to tell me that if somebody shot at you, no matter what the circumstance, somebody shot at you, you wouldn't want to have them arrested? You wouldn't want to have them prosecuted?
Well, you make a really good point.
Right,
King.
Well, that's what should happen.
But I also didn't have somebody shatter a cement block over my knee and try to intentionally trip on me and bang it into the cover, off the face, the cover, hook to the leg, and Goldust just got the shoulder up. This Maven, I'll tell you, he is a hell of a competitor, and Goldust planting Maven. Maven has a great heart, a great attitude, competitive spirit. But he's in there against a true veteran and a very dangerous Goldust.
I'm sure any cardiologist watching out there will be happy to hear that this kid has a great heart. But let me tell you what, he's got a snot nose and he's a punk. Look at this.
Now, King, how can you say that? Off the corner, face first. Goldust, look at this.
There you go.
Submission maneuver, those knees driven into the back of Maven. How can you say that about Maven? I mean, everything that this kid has accomplished, and he's been nothing but humble whenever I've talked to the kid in the back of the locker room area.
Oh, yeah, he looked real humble when he was eliminating The Undertaker, one of the biggest stars ever in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. When this punk was eliminating Undertaker from the Royal Rumble, he looked real humble, didn't he?
Undertaker should have kept his mind in the matchup, so he should have done it.
Goldust. So, you're defending Maven against The Undertaker, right?
No, he was just in the right place at the right time. He took advantage, King. And Goldust is taking advantage here. He's tossing that fire extinguisher back into the ring. All legal in this no-holds-barred matchup.
Yeah,
Maven may be
Maven,
up cold.
Maven's been hot as of late. Maybe this will cool him off a little bit right here.
Goldust. Oh, look out.
Maven! Oh! Maven! The fire extinguisher to the face of Goldust! That punk! Maven, turn the tables! Here's the cover! Maven wins again! Maven's dream continues!
I did not believe this.
And still, the World Wrestling Federation Hardcore Champion, Maven!
The Goldust could be blinded from that fire extinguisher. Can you see?
Goldust made a mistake, and now the sore loser, Goldust. Uh-oh! What the hell is this?
Uh-oh, you're right! I know what it is, and I know who it is!
What does this vile, vicious creature want?
Well, for one thing, he wants Ric Flair at WrestleMania, but he may have something else on his mind right at the moment.
Hasn't he caused enough problems already this week? An uncalled for, brutal Halloween attack on WWF official Arn Anderson.
Well, look, it's because Arn Anderson is retired, and did I mention that he's disabled? Well, and did I mention that he happens to be the best friend of Ric Flair?
Find all this humorous.
Well, with friends like Flair, you don't need any enemies, obviously.
It was a disgusting attack, and Maven struggling to get to his feet. Why doesn't The Undertaker just follow his pride? Oh, look out! And show somebody some respect for a change.
Well, look, how can you respect a Raw rookie in the WWF? Sure, he won Tough Enough. That's great. That's very impressive.
Oh!
But the fact is, he's still a rookie.
But when is enough enough? When is enough for The Undertaker to Maven?
Oh, I don't think it'll ever be enough. I mean, like you said, the humiliation that The Undertaker suffered at the hands of Maven, he'll never get over that.
Well, you saw what The Undertaker did to the legendary Arn Anderson on Raw Monday, and who knows what more he's capable of? Who knows what he could do to Maven here tonight?
No. Oh, man. Well, you don't think Maven should have expected this? I mean, when he dropped him,
wait a minute! A little bit of help!
What is that?
It's Al Snow! Maven's mentoring! Slater from Tokyo! Al Snow taking it to The Undertaker!
What are you doing, Al Snow?
He's coming to the aid of Maven is what he's doing!
What's going on here, Al Snow? Do you not respect The Undertaker?
Al Snow is all wound up!
Like a sneak attack, Michael!
You want one?
What?
Al Snow is Maven's friend kick, his mentor. He's coming to the protection of Maven, who just went through a brutal hardcore match.
Wait a minute. I think that Al Snow is actually challenging The Undertaker.
What?
Did you hear that?
I think Al Snow did challenge The Undertaker. He played the catch up. And the bell is rung. And Al Snow and The Undertaker. A one-on-one impromptu.
Look at Al Snow. He's like a man possessed.
I hope Al Snow's that's what he's doing, kid.
Never know what he's doing his entire life.
Took a tremendous amount of courage by this man to stick up for that wide-eyed rookie Maven. And a headbutt from The Undertaker. That even wobbled The Undertaker a bit.
I know Al Snow loves those tough enough kids, but I just don't know why. He's like their Uncle Al.
Al Snow with the right hand to The Undertaker. The courage of Al Snow. Oh, and a kick to the face. And Undertaker knocked out of the ring. And it hits The Undertaker. He's got his match here tonight.
Well, perhaps. But I wouldn't bet on it.
Al Snow is going totally on adrenaline. But he walked into that mistake. And it allows The Undertaker to take advantage.
And perhaps the...
steps, you can feel that shoulder.
Perhaps the Red Sox will win the World Series this coming season, but I doubt it.
Head first off the steel steps, and Al Snow can barely stand. Whoa. The Undertaker continues another vicious assault.
Let him have your chair, Michael.
And King, this has become all too commonplace for The Undertaker.
See, this is about... you're right, he did ask for this. He had for the battle!
Al Snow just moving out of the way, and Al Snow desperately, he's fighting for his life, King. The hell with the match, Al Snow is fighting for his life.
I realize that. Now he's got a chair. Where's Al Snow?
Good hand to Al Snow, The Undertaker! That big hand around the throat, Al Snow.
Oh no, not on the floor!
Showstrap! And you could hear that echo through the Fleet Center.
I can feel it. I can feel the vibration.
The Undertaker does what he wants, when he wants. And when is this all going to end?
I don't know, but I guarantee you that'll make your liver quiver. I think poor Al's got the quivering liver disease right now.
This campaign of terror has got to end.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait a minute. It's Ric Flair.
Wait a minute.
Come on to Ric Flair.
He's got no business out here. What's he doing?
Look, he's got that left pipe. The left pipe from the Taker's bike.
He's dismantled the Undertaker.
Oh! Ric Flair in the back of the head of the Undertaker.
Look out, Taker.
Ric Flair taking Undertaker. These shots, I'm sure, are for Arn Anderson.
This is no way.
Boiling with emotion.
Wait a minute. Uh-oh, what?
When it comes to WrestleMania, the answer is still no.
What?
But if you ever touch a friend of mine again, I don't care if it's the church, the parking lot, the alley, I will show you why I am the dirtiest player in the game.
Look out!
And another shot. The emotion falling through the blood, the veins of Ric Flair.
We got Madman running rampant here tonight. He ought to have his owner's license revoked.
Ric Flair with an emphatic no to the Taker's challenge of a match at WrestleMania.
Eddie,
snapped. Ric Flair will not give in to The Undertaker's campaign of brutal destruction.
Yeah, he won't give in and he won't say yes. I want to know if Impussy's afraid of The Undertaker.